Should you use a non-detergent motor oil to break in a new engine? I'm Lake Speed Jr., certified lubrication specialist, and we're going to give you the answers right now. So we took a sample of Shell non-detergent straight 30 motor oil. We bought this off the shelf at a local parts store. Now here's the thing, almost all non-detergent oils are gonna be like this. So we're not picking on Shell by any means. We're just saying non-detergent motor oils today are typically non-additized oils as well, which is what we see in these results. So we look at the viscosity, it's 11.9 centistokes, which puts it to the high side actually of a 30 grade. So all 30 grade motor oils are going to be between 9.2 centistokes and 12.5 centistokes at 100 degrees Celsius. This oil is 11.9 centistokes, so it's on the high side of being a 30, but it's still in the 30 grade range. Now looking at the oxidation value, it's a mineral-based oil, because we can know that because the oxidation value is 4. Very low oxidation value, that's an indication that it's a straight mineral oil, no synthetic added in there. Now here's the key part. Looking at the additive package, there's nothing. No zinc, no phosphorus, no calcium, no nothing. So this is not an oil that should ever be used really in any engine, by the way. This oil needs to have additives. Now, I would caution against adding some kind of zinc additive to this oil. You have to properly mix it and get the additive levels right. It's much better if you're gonna be breaking in a new engine to actually use a properly formulated break-in oil, which we'll do another video on that in the future to describe what makes a break-in oil a break-in oil, how it's different from a regular passenger car or diesel type motor oil, because there is a difference. So stay tuned to that video. Thanks for watching this one.